get out of this gross planet.
I know, it's kind of like a fart planet. Doesn't it look like a fart planet?
It reminds me of the creepy planet from that one episode of Ren and Stimpy that scared the shit out of me.
I'm not gonna remember it, so...
What?
Are we in space?
I think so.
Oh, we're still in the atmosphere?
Oh, hey!
Oh!
What's up? Are we friends? Or not? No?
Oh, you're headed right towards a thing. Whoa, lots of things. Oh! Wow.
So this is cool.
Activate hyperdrive. Open galactic map in space by pressing the down thing on that thing.
Alright, so...
Ooh.
Are things gonna be cool now? I have no idea what's going on.
So I guess we pick another planet to go visit. Whoa.
Alright.
So can you...
Well, let's just go towards the galactic core because that seems... Let's go there.
Yeah. Why not?
Okay, oh, we're... Oh, ha-ha!
I feel like I'm in the iTunes visualizer.
I'm done with the color green. I'm done with it. Are we going somewhere else now? That took an hour.
Yeah.
That was boring. Are we done? Are we at the new place now? I would be a terrible intergalactic... Actually, maybe I'd be really good at it, because there's a lot of time where you just do sit around and do nothing by yourself.
I don't think that would be good for you.
I think it would be great for me. I would love it.
I think you think you would love it, but...
Nope.
Without things to organize and...
No, decisions. No, because it would just be me in the space AI, and I'd be constantly sexually harassing it. And it'd be like, I am not programmed for that. And I'd be like, are you sure?
Yeah.
Could I program you to do such a thing? Wow. What's that thing? What is it?
Are you flying right now?
I'm trying to.
Did it just like land us in the solar system and we have to...
Figure it out, yeah. Okay, so we have to go over to that thing. Arrive in 1 hour. What the... Stacy, help me.
Yeah, but you boost, so...
Oh great, now
it's
just-
Oh boy. Oh, we gained resources from you blasting through that asteroid, so. Arrive in 1 hour.
What? Yeah.
So we didn't go anywhere? I don't understand. Or is that just like-
I don't understand.
Is that where we want to be headed?
I don't know.
I'm saying, refuel pulse engine with thamium 9. So, oh, but people were also talking about the possibility of life on, like, methane-based life on Saturn's moon Titan. Basically because it's a chemically active atmosphere with lots of carbon compounds. Nice. And some people were like, I don't know, maybe it's a planet. That's the planet made out of parts. right there.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, it is. Methane.
Yeah, it's a methane planet. It's, a, you know, it's an entire fart-based life system. You know how, like, we're all carbon-based? This is fart-based. So, you go, basically, you would go over to your friend's house on Saturn's moon, and you'd just be like, hey, you know, and they'd be like, why don't you ever come visit more often? And you'd be like, no reason. And really, it's just because their place smells.
Okay, nothing needs to be recharged, so... I guess we just got to go towards this for like 5 minutes. Isn't that exciting?
Is that the correct planet that we wanted?
It says beacon, go over there.
Okay.
So,
it says, so there's the beacon, but then, but there's also the planet which says we should arrive in 3 minutes.
Even so.
Yeah. This is...
Why was everyone excited for this?
You need to, like, just get a little bit of chill.
No.
Then the other Saturn's other, one of Saturn's other moons, or it could just be Saturn's other moon. I don't know how many it has. Two?
Several. Saturn?
Yeah.
Okay, I was just making sure.
Yeah. And that's, and Enceladus?
Everyone else has, like, so many moons and Earth has one, like... Whatever.
Oh.
And we're dead.
That's a different planet.
Whee!
That's a different planet.
Wait, hold on.
Arrive. Oh, you want to visit a different planet?
I don't know.
That's not the one.
Looks closer.
Okay.
Wait, hold on. Oh, wait, no. We're, like, right there.
We're already there. But basically, that other moon is, could be the most habitable place in our solar system besides Earth. It has a saltwater ocean underneath the South Pole. And it's frozen over, but there are hydrothermal vents similar to what's in our ocean. You know, like those, like, cracks in the ocean floor, which many people believe was... know, instrumental in getting life on Earth, and it has those vents on that moon, so those could be a place for life to alright, where are you headed?
Towards the beacon.
Oh, okay.
Apparently
I wonder if it matters where recharged deflector shield with oxide elements.
We're fine.
They've also talked about radio bursts being possible communication from other life. There were 10 bursts that were in a pattern, clearly non-organic in nature, and scientists have said that there's like about a 5 in 10,000 chance that this is... Why would you say 5 in 10,000 when you would, what you would really mean is 1 in 2,000?
Because that sounds cooler.
To say, oh, it's a 5 in 10,000 chance, it's like, you mean 1 in 2,000.
But it sounds cooler.
Yeah.
So...
I don't know.
It's a perspective thing. When you're trying to convince someone of something, and how you phrase it matters. So maybe they're like, no, it's aliens.
Yeah. I guess it just always like makes me wonder, when, I don't know. The more that you study statistics and things like that, this is why I think that everybody should have a cursory knowledge of most subjects.
No, because literally everyone will say, oh, no, it's not, it's correlation, not causation. And you're like, okay. It's like everyone says, you know, like, but that's an indicator towards further research.
That's not where I was going with this.
I know that you weren't. You're smarter than most people.
So what I was going to say is that the reason that people should have, like, at least a cursory knowledge of things like statistics is so that you can learn. And one of the things that, like, having a college education teaches you, if you're able to get it, is it's supposed to encourage you, like, critical thinking skills, so that when you get information from whatever source, you can look at the information and evaluate it.
I think you should save this for when we're on the planet, because this is, like, not interesting to watch.
Okay, so you're...
But I'm not saying what you're saying is boring, I'm just, like, save it.
Yeah.
For not going forever in one direction. Whee! How do I recharge the shield? Oh, I can charge this. How do we recharge the shield?
So there's the deflector
shield.
Oh,
here we go. Yeah, you're right. What do you want to use?
What do we have the most of?
Iron. Technology recharge. What's hyperdrive?
That's to allow us... We need a warp cell. But I would assume that's how we get, two different planets.
Whoa!
Oh boy! Oh!
Oh god, okay. How do I get out of here? Whoa! Okay. Oh, the warp jump could have saved us some fucking time.
Wow. Might wanna... Are we gonna have to land this thing? Oh boy.
Oh god. Got some nickel! We got nickel!
Oh no.
We're okay.
Oh no.
We're okay.
Oh, this is gonna make people sick. Welcome to Geek Remix, where we died in the first 5 minutes and crashed our spaceship how many times?
I don't know. Alright. We're good. Yeah, just turn it around. Here we go. Ah, go back over there. No, go back over there. Oh my god.
Oh shit. Oh my god.
This is bad.
Now we're headed back out.
I just gotta, like, head.
God, this is
hard. No! Scuffs.
Gently.
Here we go. Go back down.
If we could just get, like... Ooh.
Hey!
Coming in on a nice trajectory.
Do not ever make me
a pilot
of anything.
It's okay. I'm really bad at driving in video games.
My dad's like, yeah, I want to get a plane. I just know that's a disaster because he doesn't read the instructions for anything.
Yeah.
So he'd be like, it's fine, Mari, relax. And I'm like, I am not going to relax. Hey, this place, it looks the same. Great. It's, like, different, but the same.
Yeah.
So, I guess that's cool or whatever.
Just make sure we don't overshoot the beacon too much. Oh, we got water.
That's cool. How do I land?
Well done. Eventually.
Something like that, I guess. Smoldering. Flora. Fauna.
Euclid Galaxy.
Cool. Please let there be something cool happening. Oh, a red thing.
Outpost.
Cool. Alright, let's go then.
Radio signal detected. Find source of life signs.
Cool. Okay, life signs.
Uh-oh.
No, I think those are our dudes. It's cool. As long as we... Oh. Hey, dinosaurs! Hi.
Hey.
Wanna be my friend?
Be my friend?
Uh-oh. What's that?
That doesn't sound friendly. What was that? Oh!
A weird butt thing. What is that?
Baby butt things.
No, I think that's a different type of butt thing.
Oh.
Oh. What's this about? Did you know that millions and millions of years ago, plants used to be purple?
Oh, okay.
Because there was, like, you know how the chlorophyll is green?
Yeah.
There was, like, another thing that could also absorb energy from the sun. I can't remember what it was called, but
it was purple.
We still
have leafy plants that are purple.
Yeah, but it's like not the same thing.
Yeah, yeah.
It's, like, something else. But, so not all plants use chlorophyll, but it used to be a long, long, long time ago, like, way back, way, way, way back.
Yeah.
Plants were purple because before they evolved to figure out, you know.
Chlorophyll.
Chlorophyll. Like, evolution doesn't really, like, figure things out, but you know what I mean. Birds. Everything was purple. Isn't that kind of weird?
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Look up. Look at that.
Cool.
You know, I was thinking about this the other night as I was coming home and I was looking at the moon and I was like, man, it's so crazy that the moon is something, like, I see it all the time, and yet I still, every time I look at it, I'm just like, you know, amazed by it.
Mm-hmm.
Which is so weird because, you know, you would think you would get used to seeing it.
Nope, cosmic entity in the sky.
Yeah, but I guess it's just like this reminder of how...
I always think it's cool how people always associate the moon with a female deity. You know what I mean? Like, it's always a female for the moon, in my opinion. From what I've seen of all.
Except for the man in the moon.
Yeah, but that's not a deity. That's just some guy hanging out.
Yeah.
But, like, if you ever think about it, like, every legend I've ever heard about the moon has always been female, and the sun has always been male.
Yeah, I've never heard any of them, so I had no such attachment to it.
Oh. Well, you know, like, Greek mythology, Native American mythology, like, pretty much, like, I used to love to read folk tales and stuff.
Yeah.
And the sun was always a dude, and the male, and the moon was always a female.
Look at that.
So I just thought that was cool.
We could go swimming, unless that's acid, and then let's not.
Let's do it. What's this? Oh, it's...
Maybe not.
Hey, it's okay.
Oh, okay. For some reason, like...
Temperature level's stabilizing, but now we're too wet. We're getting too wet. Haha! Oh. Hello! It's supposed to be super hot on here, so it makes sense why everything is kind of reptilian looking.
Yeah. Oh, we feed it!
Oh my god! It's so happy!
This should be our thing. We should just go to every planet and feed all the animals. They're gonna leave signs on all the planets we've been to, like, please stop feeding the space animals.
Do not feed the animals. I just went camping, they were like, don't feed the bears. And secretly in my head, I was like, I'm gonna feed those bears. I'm gonna give those bears. I am gonna give those bears everything at once. Like I always say, if bears don't wanna get pet, then why are they so cute?
Ah. Oh, plants.
Plants? Oh, you're looking at the purple plants?
Well, yeah, I wanted to see what,
plants used to be purple.
Evolution of photosynthesis.
Haha!
Early Earth was purple, study suggests.
Haha! You impressed by my knowledge of purple plants?
No, I wanted to figure out what, like, the...
the chemical was called?
Well, this is like a... They might have used...
Nope, it is. It's true. Everything used to be purple. It was awesome. Now everything's green and it sucks.
A scientist claims. So this is like...
A super awesome scientist.
Yeah.
Dr. Swag.
Really groovy scientist suggests that plants might have been purple.
Wearing purple glasses.
So chlorophyll, the main photosynthetic pigment of plants, absorbs mainly blue and red wavelengths from the sun and reflects green ones, and it is this reflected light that gives plants the green color. But the sun transmits most of its energy in the green part of the visible spectrum. So this guy basically thinks that this is because chlorophyll appeared after another light-sensitive molecule called retinol was already present on Earth. Retinol is found in plum-colored
leaves?
Stuff.
Stuff? Okay.
Bunch of stuff. It goes into a bunch of, like, science words that I can read if you want, but...
We don't need that. We don't need that science!
Primitive microbes that used retinol to harness the sun's energy might have done... I'm reading this from Live Science, by the way, if anybody wants to go look for this. It is called Early Earth Was Purple, Study Suggests.
Okay, go ahead. Keep on.
So, primitive microbes that used retinol to harness the sun's energy might have dominated early Earth, the scientist said, thus tinting some of the first biological hotspots on the planet a distinctive purple color. But chlorophyll was more efficient, which is why the balance tipped in favor of chlorophyll.
So I wonder if there's distant planets out there with suns that have, like, a different UV spectrum or something. I don't know. I'm not a space scientist.
Well, I just wonder if he's right.
I know he's right because it's cool. So... Okay, so I need to go...
Caution needed.
For what?
A geochemist calls the purple earth hypothesis quote-unquote interesting, but cautions against making too much of one observation. Oh, but this is... It's a cow head on a giraffe butt. Okay, but anyways, this actually plays into what I was saying earlier, which is that if you
we saw that crab butt penis thing on the other planet.
Yeah. Oh. But anyways, as I was saying, when we were in space, so mm-hmm. pick up that conversation.
Stacy and I were in space, yeah.
When we were in space, was that if you have kind of like a basic knowledge of a lot of different areas, then it like at least gives you the power to like look at information and being like, can I evaluate this source to see if I think it's worth it?
Mac farted.
Aww.
Oh, it's cute when Mac farts? You can smell it now?
Yeah.
You think it's cute when Mac farts, but not when AJ farts? I see how it is.
No, well, I thought you said that because you heard it, not because you smelled it.
Oh.
Like, I thought you just heard a little, like, pew, pew. But anyways,
I just want to look at this weird thing.
As I was saying, so I think that if people are, like, aware of where there can be shortcomings and biases in science and statistics, that can allow you to, you know, look at things with, like, a more critical eye than just, like, hey, I saw this somewhere, and so now I think it's true, you know? because you shouldn't always. Oh,
that's our ship. Yeah. I guess it was like, hey, what up? Oh, this is somebody's place. Oh, hey! Hey, howdy. What's up?
Can we talk? Scholar entity.
Entity? Oh, I guess we're in a world, we're in a universe in which aliens exist.
But still looks humanoid.
Yeah, wow. How human, no, what's a...
Human-centric?
Human-centric or, human-normative. Human-normative.
Human-normative?
Yeah! Alright, let me, like, throw some shit away. Alright. Let's see. What can I repair?
Technology recharge. Oh, but an alternate explanation for why chlorophyll doesn't absorb the green light? Is that in doing so, it might actually harm plants, much in the way that we would be poisoned if we were to inhale, like, 100% oxygen.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
Yeah. So basically, it's like, if you, like, if the Earth's atmosphere was, like, 100% oxygen, we would all be poisoned.
Mm-hmm. Do you know that millions and millions of years ago, when the oxygen level was higher, giant bugs roamed the Earth?
Yes, you discussed that in your Fallout 4 video.
Yeah. I hated... I was watching ancient creatures, or some, you know, Discovery Channel thing where they're like, yeah, like, this is what the Earth used to be like. And then it just was like, and then there used to be 6-meter-long centipedes. I was like, late, I'm out. No thanks.
No, thank you.
No, thank you. I don't want that.
It's like that. It's like that island on... in the King Kong movie where they're just like walking around, they're like, whoa, isn't this cool, big plants, and then these humongous bugs come up out of the ground. When I was watching that movie, I haven't seen it,
but don't worry about spoiling, I don't have any plans.
I mean,
I don't have any plans when I'm watching it.
So I was watching that with like my boyfriend, and up until that point I was kind of like, whatever this seems, and then that part came on. And I, like, ran screaming from the room, and I was like, I don't want to come back in until the bugs are gone! And they were like, okay, fine. So then they wait a while, they call me back in, bugs are still there, and I hated him forever.
Sorry to make us wait for the scholar entity, Linkar, but I have a similar story, I guess. But when I was, like, 12, 13, and 14, or whatever, for 2 summers, I went to Puerto Rico, in the mountains to build houses and like septic tanks and stuff. And we were at this place and we had to go down this like sort of path to clean the dishes. I turn around, there's the biggest fucking centipede I'd ever seen in my life. It was literally 1 foot long. Look up Puerto Rican centipede. Look it up. Look that shit up. And I want you to imagine doing some fucking dishes barefoot. Barefoot, I'll have you know.
Yeah.
Turning around, and the biggest fucking centipede you've seen in your life is there. Look how huge it is. Look how big it is.
This girl seems like she just wants to hang out.
It's 12 inches long, and they're huge. They're gigantic, and they have videos of these centipedes fighting snakes. And I'm afraid of, like, long spindly things unless it's a snake. Like, snakes I'm cool with, but, like, worms and centipedes I cannot deal with. Stop looking at it.
Centipedes in my vagina?
Yeah, that's a really old meme. But, like, I was like, oh, my God. So I jumped over it and ran. And ever since then, I've been afraid of penises. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Okay, I can't look at those pictures anymore.
So get out of there.
I cannot discern if the entity is flesh, machine, or both. Lights flicker across its visor, but it is motionless. Then its head nods mechanically, just once, towards a slate nearby. With a start, I realize that I can understand the text on it. I look to the entity for answers, but it remains still and silent. I suspect it is a mere courier, not the author of this message. The slate also contains a blueprint for a new technology, a hyperdrive. Instructions on how to traverse the stars. This will be invaluable. Calm blue lights dart across...
I didn't do anything.
Okay.
Oh, okay, we need a dynamic resonator.
Craft products. So that's exosuit. We want to go to starship, I would assume. Ooh.
I'm gonna make that just because. Hyperdrive.
So, hyperdrive. Warp cell.
So what is it we needed to make?
I don't know. Oh, it's that thing. The one to the right. Beam intensifier. To speed up terrain destruction. Speed up your terrain destruction!
Okay, so we gotta fuel the hyperdrive. We gotta go to the space station.
The spaceship?
We gotta go. Return to your star. What?
What? Oh.
Kind of your diffs.
The electronic lifeform readies data pertaining to the cargo it carries and the estimated worth of its starship.
Sell items to the lifeform. I want to sell the, oh. Okay. Oh, antimatter.
Oh, yeah.
But we have 0 units.
So. Oh, yeah.
Return to your starship. Oh, it's all the way over there! Oh. Okay.
Well, we have to find stuff on the way, so...
That's great.
It almost looks like it's getting dark out.
Probably is. Some shit home. Do I need this right now?
Oh, and if you guys hear anybody talking about Goldilocks planets, it's basically where they exist in that happy medium of where liquid water can exist and life. So, the whole, like, not too hot, not too cold, that type of thing. And it's basically, you know, that happy distance from their star or sun so that, you know, water can actually exist without being frozen or evaporating off the surface.
Have you ever seen the movie Knowing with Nicolas Cage?
Knowing?
my God. It's about, like, this guy, like, aliens or angels or something. And, like, it's so ridiculous. I'm thinking about explaining it. It's so stupid.
Hold on. Let me look up. You focus on mining. I'm going to pull up a description.
Of the movie Knowing?
Yeah.
Just look up a plot summary.
Yeah.
Of the movie Knowing.
Nicholas Cage. Okay.
Okay, so...
Do you want a whole plot summary, or you just want...
So, like, he's like a math teacher who figures out that the catastrophic events of the world are a pattern towards the end of the world, but it's, like, a Noah's Ark end of the world, and aliens are actually... are, like, trying to kidnap kids, but they turn out to be alien angels who are aliens, and they drop the kids off at, like, a new...
At their school?
At a new planet. And, like, all the adults die and shit. Because... Oh. Why not? I don't know what's going on. Let me out!
Okay, so 50 years after it was buried in a time capsule, a schoolgirl's cryptic document falls into the hands of Caleb Costler, the son of Professor John Costler, Nicolas Cage. John figures out that the encoded message accurately lists every major disaster from the past 5 decades and predicts 3 future calamities. One, a global cataclysm. When his warnings fall on deaf ears, John enlists the help of the prophetic author's daughter and granddaughter to try to avert the ultimate disaster.
Yeah, which was predicting that aliens were coming to, like, reap the planet and make a new, like, Eden, pretty much. They were taking boys and girls and, like, leaving them on the planets. On new alien planets, like sets of boys and girls.
Wait, aliens to the, are you
like alien spaceship angels?
Yeah,
alien spaceship angels came.
So the aliens were leaving Earth children on planets, or the aliens were leaving their own children on planets?
Okay, so the aliens kidnapped the Earth children and destroyed Earth. They just kidnapped a bunch of like random like Earth children, destroyed Earth because alien is Jesus or something. And then they just drop those kids off at a new planet. I think it's supposed to be, like, a retelling of Noah's Ark or something. Because, yeah. You know, like, God was like, hey, you guys are, like, fucked up. Like, I'm gonna kill everyone because you guys, like, can't handle it or something.
Yeah.
And so I guess that's what the aliens decided. Like, oh, you guys are weird again, so...
Oh, so our spaceship's just over there.
Yep, 2 minutes away. So anyway, it was the best movie ever. Just like every Nicolas Cage movie that totally makes sense. It's awesome.
Oh, what's this? Did somebody... This looks like somebody, like, threw their refrigerator. Like, their old dishwasher out of their spaceship. Like... Like, somebody's driving in their spaceship and they're just like, oh, this piece of crap is broken again. Oh, just dump it on this planet. But yeah, that movie scored a sweet 34% on Rotten Tomatoes.
It's awesome, though. You guys should watch it.
An amazing 6.2 on IMDb. 4 out of 4.
Have you ever noticed that...
4 out of 4 from Roger Ebert.
What's up with that dude?
He's dead?
Well, but you know what I mean with his scores, though.
Oh.
Like, his scores are always, like, don't make sense.
Never something I paid attention to.
Like, why do people care?
What?
Like, his scores for movies always felt really weird. Also, have you noticed that every single movie in the world on IMDb is always rated at a 6-point-something?
No.
No matter how good or how bad it is, it's always 6-point-something.
I don't think that's true.
Every time I've looked up the star rating for any movie, it's always been 6-point-something.
Maybe you're just always looking up mediocre movies.
Excuse me, was the movie Hook mediocre?
Hook?
Look it up. It's gonna say 6-point-something on IMDb.
6.7.
See? And look up a different movie. So it was Knowing and then, like, Hook.
All Sunshine, 7.3.
Oh, well, okay.
Event Horizon, 6.7.
Ha-ha! It's always 6 point something.
There's,
What? Look up another movie.
Interstellar, 8.6.
Okay, well, that's Interstellar. But can you believe they gave Hook 6.7? Like, who do they think they are?
Who do they think they are?
Hook is...
The movie is a treasure!
Rufio was...
Doesn't
matter if you're a guy or a girl, he was your crush.
Yeah.
Whether you want to admit it or not.
Yeah.
You're lying if you're saying that you were not sexually attracted to Rufio.
Rufio sexual. That sounds like Rufy sexual,
I'm not gay, I'm just into Rufio. That's the only reason, I'm only gay for Rufio.
Yeah. So are we supposed to get in our starship and then drive to the space station?
Oh, great. That sounds so exciting. Alright, here we are. Travel to space station. Okay. Is that the space station? I'm upside down.
Yep. You're, doing great.
I don't know how to, like, fix my orientation. I don't know how to fly! Amazing. Hi, what's up? I don't know how to fix my orientation at all. I wonder how good this game would look on the PC, because you can definitely see it's being held back a little by the PS4.
Yeah. But would it matter? I mean, honestly, from what we've looked at so far,
I think it would matter. Like, it looks like a PS2 game down there, I mean.
But I mean, like, even when you're on the surface,
it's just blah.
Yeah.
You're talking about, like, the content of...
Yeah. It's like, ooh, boy, it's like if you look at... Where are you going?
So the off-planet space station, apparently.
Off-planet space station? Aren't you supposed to choose one? Like, off-planet or space station? Oh. You're right. Let's just travel to space station. Well.
Ah, here we go. See, planetary interference. So I think I just have to go up.
Oh, so we're going to the space station. Yeah. Off planet.
So I have to get, like, around the thing. Okay.
It's pointing that way.
I know how to get there, I just can't get there, if that makes sense.
Yeah. There it is. So we pass by it on the way in, I'm pretty sure that's what we pass by.
Oh my god! This is so bad! Just turn! Okay. Oh! Alright, I guess gotta point myself. Just
point yourself there.
And then...
There we go. And then maybe we can slingshot ourselves around the planet, right?
Yeah, let's explain what slingshotting is 3 times to the audience, and then they'll know. Here, we're all space engineers. Let me use this pen to explain space shit. Whoa!
Oh boy.
Died.
It saved you. It was like, hey, you're coming in a little hot, okay?
I know, I got out of hyperdrive just in time.
No, it disabled it for you.
Oh. No, the answer is I'm good at video games. It's so hot in here.
I know.
I'm dying. Okay, I'm at the space station, apparently.
It says arrive in. Nope.
The controls are not exactly intuitive. So. Oh, here's the entrance. Here we go. Whoa. I didn't do that.
Oh boy. Alright.
Oh, this reminds me of that one part from. From Independence Day, where they figure out how to destroy the ships.
By going in it?
Yeah. Okay, so now we're on a space station. That's cool. I wish I could run.
So, buy antimatter from Galactic Trade Terminal.
Okay.
Are we gonna get to see aliens?
Can I have some of your water? I'm really thirsty.
Yeah, did you drink all yours?
Yeah. Just drink almost all your water. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay.
I need an Atlas pass, okay? Oh, over there. Gosh, I'm a silly Billy.
It's so hot in this room.
I'm dying.
I feel okay.
Okay.
But I know that you're also a lot more stressed out than I am. So,
I can't. I don't have any anti-anxiety pills. Well, my mom got a car crash.
What?
Hey. I wonder if the humans are the aliens and we're an alien. You know, does that make sense?
We're all aliens.
You know what I meant, though, right?
No.
We're playing as a non-human, but all the people we're seeing are humans.
Possible.
Like, wouldn't that be kind of cool?
Yeah.
What up?
Buy items from Galactic Trade, but we don't have any,
Let's see what we can sell.
Oh, you could, did you see how much you could sell that for the units? So that's... But first we should probably check how many units we need.
What do we need to buy?
Antimatter.
So we need 5...
52,000.
Alright. Let's just sell some shit then. Platinum. What do we use platinum for?
I mean, we're gonna have to sell a lot of stuff, so. Units received. Units received.
Units received. Units received. You don't have enough?
No.
Alright, I am done playing this for tonight.
Yeah, that's fine.